Today at Tawari Khwani, in the series of lesser known stories from historical accounts, we are presenting the story of a man whose description has been interwoven with the history of Rampur. Located 214 kilometers east of Indian capital Delhi, the princely state of Rampur is a place of historical importance. Almost 200 years old, this princely state was merged with independent India on 15th May 1949. The present Rampur seems to be in a struggle with its historical heritage. At many places, we saw the grand palatial buildings are turning in ruins, while some of the historical landmarks are erased due to the reluctance of local politicians. In 2019, we had a chance to visit and explore the heritage of this beautiful town. We tried to find the tomb of its founder, Nawab Faizullah Khan. Unfortunately, in this era of technology, the place is not even marked on Google Maps and even no one was able to guide us. Finally, a senior employee of Raza Library guided us for the location. Nawab Faizullah Khan, the founder of Rampur State, was a son of Nawab Ali Muhammad Khan. He was born in 1730 at Aula, a town in the present Bareilly district. On 15 September 1748, when his father passed away, the entire Rohilla Confederacy came under the control of Hafiz Rehmat Khan as a guardian. In 1754, when Hafiz Rehmat Khan divided the entire Rohilla territories in small chieftaincies, among the major sardars and the sons of Nawab Ali Muhammad Khan, the Nawab Faizullah Khan got the Rampur as his jagir. Ahmad Ali Khan, Shauk Rampuri, in his account, The History of Raza Library Rampur, quoted that Nawab Faizullah Khan received Shahabad and Rampur as his jagir. In fact, he wrote that the town was established by Nawab Faizullah Khan. Here is the succinct background of its establishment as a separate state. On 23rd April 1774, a decisive battle took place at Miranpur Katra between the joint forces of Awadh and East India Company, with Rohillas under their leader Hafiz Rehmat Khan. The Rohillas lost the battle after the fall of their leader, but Faizullah Khan displayed his bravery during the war. Contrary to the other Rohilla chieftains who accepted the defeat, he retreated with his soldiers in the dense forest of Garhwal Hills. The entire Rohilkhand that was spread over an area of 12,000 square miles came under the rule of Shuja-ud-Dawla. The joint forces of Nawab Awadh and the East India Company under Colonel Champion got fatigued in this Rohilla war with the Pashtuns in rough terrain. Finally, with the mediation of Colonel Alexander Champion, a treaty was proposed on 17th October 1774. It was signed at a place known as Lal Dang in Haridwar, so it became popular in history as a Treaty of Lal Dang. The famous Sufi saint of Rampur, Shah Jamalullah, was also present with Nawab Faizullah Khan during this historical accord. Some of the relevant points of this treaty are that the total area with the annual revenue of 15 lakh was given to Nawab Faizullah Khan. He was not allowed to keep the forces more than 5,000. The enemies of the Awadh will be considered as the enemy of Rampur state and vice versa will be applicable. Regarding the sketches of Faizullah Khan's life, the author of Tariq-e-Rampur, Shaukat Ali Khan, wrote, "He was prudent and pious in his behavior and enjoyed the company of literary and educated people. The state of Rampur flourished by his efforts. When there was a general chaos in Rohilkhand after the fall of Rohilas, he gave a refuge to the sons of many notable leaders such as Mohibullah Khan, son of Dudi Khan, Ahmad Khan, son of Bakshi Sardar Khan, Azam Khan, son of Fateh Khan. After the war, they went back to their principalities, keeping the promises of Nawab Awadh. But now their land have been seized and they were expelled from their territories. People from the far lands and the neighboring places from diverse faith got settled in Rampur during this phase. A huge number of scholars, Sufis, artists and jurists were invited to Rampur. A huge library was also established by him that was later inherited to Rampur as a library. In those days, the Rampur was titled as Bukhara-e-Hind, that means Bukhara of North India, or in fact Hind or India. On 17 July 1794, he departed from this world after a reign of 20 years. His resting place was located near the gateway of Eidgah. His open-air tomb, surrounded by a walled enclosure, is a reflection of its simple design. There was a mosque located adjacent to his tomb that was renovated by Nawab Hamid Ali Khan. It was designed by his chief engineer W.C. Wright. With the time, the mosque also has lost its architectural beauty. I think here the small verse of Iqbal is contextual with the condition of Nawab Faizullah Khan. Nahi is khuli fiza mein koi goshay faragat, ये जहां अजब जहां है कफस न आशियां। थैंक यू फॉर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो, होप यू हैव लाइक आवर हेरिटेज स्टोरी, एंड इफ यू लाइक आवर हेरिटेज स्टोरी प्लीज डू सब्सक्राइब एंड शेयर द वाली खानी। Please do don't forget to click the bell icon button to get the future notifications. Thank you and see you again.